actually, I've been a writer for 20 years, but I, for my day job, I work with men and women who are facing execution. So by working with these men who are facing execution, I became very interested in their stories. And that led to this novel. I wanted to write a novel that captured the stories of people who are facing execution and who live in prisons. Well, one thing I wanted to do with the novel is to show how people overcome living in despair and overcome living in terrible places. So the novel explores how this man lives in this awful, awful, despairing dungeon, and yet in his mind he creates a very magical, enchanting place. In English, there's a very much a contradiction between a prison where people go away and disappear and the concept of an enchanted place, but not so much in chains. I mean, I think it's a language difference, perhaps. Well, I've always wanted to write fiction. I've written nonfiction books before, but I think I was inspired by my work, working with people who are facing execution. But I feel I have a lot more stories to tell as well, so I'm going to keep writing fiction. But this one was very much a celebration for me of everything I've learned through my work and in my life as well. Donald Ray Pollock, who's here at the festival, is one of my heroes, and I've never met him. I don't know who, you know, never had any contact with him, but he read The Enchanted and loved it as well. Donald Ray Pollock's an amazing writer. I would choose him. Devil all the time, yes. He better choose me or he's in trouble.